Okey.
Siapa kahwin dulu?
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and welcome to this week I'm going to get it right. Welcome to the fourth Advenshare time session. Advenshare session. Dah banyak sangat dah. Advenshare session. Padahal sendiri punya tau. And this week I macam extra excited hari ni sebenarnya sebab normally I do the sessions bersama geng-geng I yang macam I dah kenal. And this is the first week and the first time I jumpa Neollene.
Assalamualaikum. I'm Neollene. So basically I'm a filmmaker, photographer, videographer and yeah, people call me traveller.
Okay. So people think you're a traveller but you're actually a filmmaker.
Yeah, I'm a filmmaker. People thought that I didn't do any job, I'm not working and then money just datang daripada langit.
Amin. So you started off as an architecture student. So you did your part 1 and you did your part 2. And then how did you get into videography? I mean from architecture to
I think everyone started off with photography. When I was in school, I'm the one who actually took everybody's picture at school and then the one who actually the editor for the school magazine. That one during my school lah. Right. Maybe after some time I discovered that I'm so into photography. I'm so into like handling cameras, those technical stuff kan. And then when I was in university, kan kita ada like architectural workshop, so ada multimedia competition. Still remember tak? So me with my friends, we actually entered competition. We sent our short film. And alhamdulillah, we managed to won lah the first runner up and also the first place for the short film. So since
under architectural workshop.
Since that I actually I discovered that I'm so into this filmmaking thingy, this videography. So rasa macam okay, maybe probably I have talent in that. After finishing my part 2, I got an offer to actually join a production company.
So memang the production company macam offered you. How did they find you semua macam tu?
From social media, from YouTube.
During 2016
masa tu.
So even during university, you were uploading all your short film works and were you doing videography as a side hobby juga?
Yes, as a side hobby and side income. Macam at that particular time, I actually did videography for wedding. As well as short film. I started to travel, I make video of travel video lah.
Tapi that was your hobby?
That is my hobby.
Okay. Let's go to the hot topic of travelling kat sini. How did you start travelling? Like, when was your first country? How did you save up for it?
So, after I finished my study, I decided to travel far. Masa tu I pergi Europe, pergi London.
Masa tu guna duit sendiri.
I save up during my study lah. Orang cakap macam senang, very macam mana datang duit daripada langit kan. Tapi macam you guys tak tahu, you guys don't even know that I really save up for my travel because I think that is my priority. Because I think that masa tu I rasa sangat nak explore the world. That is macam I nak achieve my dream lah. So I think in life kan, if we want to do something we need to really sacrifice tau. Nothing comes easy in life lah.
I agree so much. So macam again ramai juga yang tanya I the same thing. But I always answer if you really want something and inshallah if it's meant for you, memang if you want something
you will get it.
If you work for it, if you prioritize it, inshallah it will happen.
I macam sebelum ni I rasa macam I sangat curious about what other people in other parts of the world are doing tau. Macam I tak tahu macam bila sampai sana sangat broaden up my apa thinking. I rasa macam I the way I see things tu jadi lebih macam sangat broad, sangat lain lah. I rasa macam sangat different bila I balik. So benda tu buatkan kita macam I need to travel more.
And obviously for you it broaden your horizon in the sense of it opened up career opportunities for you.
Alhamdulillah. I tak plan for it. I didn't plan for it. Tapi it happens along the way when I travel tu. Macam ada some agency came to me asking whether whether I nak collaborate dengan diorang atau tak. Like do the marketing for them, do the photography and videography for them.
Out of curiosity, what was one of the most memorable experiences that you had while traveling?
Yang paling macam you just want one lah.
Kalau boleh, one that like really stands out.
Oh, really stands. Okay. I always said to people yang macam, I think the first my travel experience yang macam wow to me is bila I got to see Aurora for the first time.
Oh.
For the
first time. Cik, umur kan? No. Dia cakap for the first time, weh.
No, so, betul lah.
Obviously, she's seen it like, oh, Aurora. Macam berapa kali dah? Berapa kali dah nampak Aurora ni?
Alah, nanti orang kata aku pula 3 kali, 4 kali macam tu.
3 kali je. Aurora, weh. Aurora. Okay.
Wow, masa tu memang sangat rasa macam how fantastic God's creation are. Macam macam mana we can see those curtain lights, macam curtain kan, macam dancing in the sky during night hours, macam the lights very blooming, glimmering.
If you could say something to okay. your younger self,
okay,
what would you say?
I think be more appreciative of time kot. Macam maksudnya macam I should appreciate time more. For example, like don't waste my time buat benda-benda yang not useful, buat benda-benda yang tak berfaedah untuk hidup. I think from daripada young lagi, kita should do something yang lebih bermanfaat untuk hidup. Macam I rasa I dah waste too many times, in which kalau I started early in my younger age,
oh, I rasa early. I dah... Padahal dia dah dari sekolah tau, dia tekat gambar. I rasa... You nak early mana lagi? Seriously.
So I rasa macam masa I sekolah tu, I macam huha-huha banyak.
Wait,
sangat.
I sekarang pun huha-huha lagi kot, ya Allah.
Okay. Lemak. Siapa kami dulu?
Silakan. Habiskan. Apa lagi tip?
Apa lagi tips? Itulah cakap. First kali, if you have a dream, go for it. Jangan tunggu. Don't wait for a right time. Mm-hmm. Do it from now. It's either you rasa, kalau you rasa you are not the best yet, but you are climbing it. You are climbing the mountains. Maknanya you on the way to it. Yeah. Tahu. So jangan tunggu the right time untuk jadi terbaik, tapi you kena usaha.
Yep.
So dream, work hard and play hard.
Gitu. I rasa, I nak tambah sikit. I rasa, I think that people should understand juga macam failure is part of the process. Failure and finding out that you're not good at something, finding out that something memang really is not meant for you, is actually part of the journey.
Betul.
So macam, if memang you dah cuba secuba-cuba pun, but memang somehow tak dapat, it's either you might get it later or you might throw memang something
right
for
time.
You and something better is there for you.
Yes.
Yang penting memang usaha tu and the creativity and pursuing something, the pursuit of something tu tak kisahlah apa, is important kan?
Yes. Be extraordinary, itu je.
Alright guys, itulah kata-kata nasihat daripada akak Neollene kita.
Oh my god.
Bukan akak lah. Hey. Okay, auntie. Cuma tentu saja.
Eh betul, I ada nephew dengan nephew
sesama. Okay, tak apa. Daripada saudari Neollene kita. Alhamdulillah. Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.